Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. My name is Harisa. I will tell you a little about the story Atom the Class of the Titans. This is story of the great science discovery. Ever the discovery that everything is made of atoms, the vast variety and richness of everything. We seen around us in the world and beyond how it boil up, how it all fits together is all down to atoms and the mysterious law they obey. As science delve into the atoms, the very part of matter they unravel natures. Most shocking secret they had to abandon everything they believe in and create a whole new science, a science that today on the fins the world of physics, chemistry, biology, and maybe even life. It's but for me, the story of how humanity solved the mystery of the atom is both inspiring and remarkable. It's a story great genius of men and women, driven by their desire for knowledge. And glory its story of full star and conflict of ambition and reflection, a story that leads or struck some of the most exciting and exhilarating idea ever conceived of by human race and for a working physics. Like me, it's the most important story there is. The 5th of October 1906, in a hotel room near Thurs, a German science called Ludwig Boltzmann hanged himself. Boltzmann had a long history of physiology problems, and one of the key factors in his depression was that he'd been believed, even ostracized, for believing something that today we take for granted. He believed that matter cannot be infinite, divisible into ever smaller pieces. Instead, he argued that ultimately everything is made of basic building blocks, atoms. It seems incredible now that Boltzmann's reflection was so controversial, but 800 years ago, arguing atoms were real was considered by most to be a waste of time. Although we sort of sense the Greek had speculated that the world might be made out of some kind of basic unit of matter, they realized that they were far too small to see even under the most powerful microscopes. Speculating about them was therefore a complete waste of the time, but in the middle of the 19th century, whether on the atom was real was suddenly a question of burning importance. The reason was distinct by the 18th and 50, it was changing the world. Import the mighty ions that range the ships of the factor of the industry revolution. So figuring out how to use it more effectively became a matter of crucial commercial, political, and military significance. Not surface, then it became the key question of 19th century since the demand to build question of the 19th century since the demand to build more powerful and advanced steam engines into created an organ need to understand and predict the behavior of water and steam at high temperature and pressures. Ludwig Boltzmann and his science allies solid that if you imagine steam is made of millions of tiny wiggly savory atoms, then you can create some powerful mathematical equations, and the equations are capable of predicting the behavior of steam with incredible accuracy. But these same equations alarmed Boltzmann and his fellow atomists. In the controversy, their enemies argued that since the atoms referred to in their calculations were invisible, merely a mathematical convenience rather than real physical object, to claim that even now and it is very real in presence, even blasphemous. You see, Boltzmann's critics argue that it was sacrilegious to reduce God's miraculous creations down to a series of collisions between tiny inanimate spheres. Boltzmann was condemned as in irreligious materialist, the magic irony or false and story. If that's when he took his own life in 1906, he was unaware that he had been vindicated. You see, a year before he did, a young sense had published a paper which undeniable irrefutable proclaimed the reality of the atom. You might have heard of this young scientist's name was Albert Einstein. In 1905, the years before Boltzmann's switch, Albert Einstein was 26 years old. His brass arrangements had upset most of the professors and teachers, and he was barely employable. Then he got his girlfriend pregnant, that was followed by a hasty marriage. He needed a job, any job, having not quit. Distinguished himself at university, he took up a job as a patent clerk there in Bern, in Switzerland. He moved in the smell on the bedroom apartment on Crime Gasser with his view. Away from a labor, despite their personal stress, the young Einstein had a burning ambition. He was desperate to make his mark as a physical, and in 1905, during on miraculous yet the mark he made was truly incredible. Having an undemanding job meant that young Einstein had plenty of time on his hands, but at work and here in his tiny apartment to ding dev talks. In the space of just a few months, he wished to publish several papers that would change science forever. Now everyone heard of his theory of relativity, even if they don't understand it, and his paper on the nature of light was to win him the Nobel Prize a few years later. But ironically, it was either of the two papers that had the most impact on the discovery of atoms, the one that made all the difference, was a short paper on how tiny grains of pollen dance in the water along 18 years earlier in 1827. Rostock botanist Carl Robert Brown sprinkled pollen grains in some water and examined it through a microscope. What I found was really strange, because instead of the pollen grains floating gently in the water, they danced around furiously, almost a stop They were alive now, while this so-called Browning motion was strange, science soon forgot about it. They found in mundane, even burning. I mean, who cares if the pollen giggled about in the weather, and what had the jiggling to do with atoms anyway? For early 18 years, Brown's discovery remained a little canal sense anomaly. Then Einstein changed everything in one strike, staggering insight. Einstein saw that Browning motion was all about atoms in the fact release that the jingling of pollen grains in the weather call settled the raging debate about the reality of atoms forever. His argument was simple: the pollen will only jiggle if they were being jostled by something else. So Einstein said that the weather must be made of tiny atoms like particles, which themselves are jiggling and are continue buffeting the pond. In if there were no atoms, then the pollen would stay still. So Boltzmann and his contemporaries had been rowing furiously about this question for nothing. The answer was there all along. Einstein proved that for Brownian motion to happen, atoms must exist. Einstein's paper went way beyond just verbal arguments. With flawless mathematics, he proved that the density of the pollen revealed the size of the atom and its mean numbing of millions of a millimeter across a single human eye itself, one of the narrowest things visible to the naked eye, is over a million atoms. Wait, let me put in another way: there are more atoms in a single glass of water than there are glass of water in all the oceans of the world. Sort of horse your head used to think. And that's a little story for me. Thank you.